Gravesend Australia Diecast Salvage. We will get to play with Matchbox cars, Dinky toys, Corgi toys, Majorette, and quite a number of other different brands that are out there. Adult supervision required at all times. You just never know what's going to pop up on your screen. Content on this channel is aimed at the adult community as it contains strippers. So hot, you'll take the paint off vehicles. Nudity. Naked vehicles. And a man playing with his tools. What else is he going to do? We've got strippers and we've got nude cars. He has to play with something. Here are some of our previous attempts to give these vehicles a new lease of life. And I think I did not a bad job, if I do say so myself. But there's always room for improvement. So come along to see what's in today's episode at Gravesend Australia Diecast Salvage. In this episode, we're dealing with a Matchbox Speed Kings Audi Quatro. As you can see, the doors open, and bottom opens. It has a slightly detailed engine to it. Oh, I have to do a shout out to Paul from Pimp My Diecast for the spoiler that's on the back. So, thumbs up, mate. Thank you for passing that on so we can complete this car. So, we'll go over to the workbench and have a close look at it. So, we'll see you there. Alright, so now that we're here at the workbench, we can have a closer look at the vehicle. And if I hold it that way, I might be able to see what it is there. It is Matchbox Speed Kings Audi Quattro 1982 made in Macau. Anyway, it does have suspension. Like I said, this spoiler part here was kindly donated by Paula Pimp My Diecast. So, as we saw on the turntable, doors do open. And we have a detailed engine to it. So as you can see, she's paintwork's in rough condition. We're going to retire it from doing its rally. I think it's had enough. So she's going to go into civilian life. So we'll catch you in a moment where we'll pull the vehicle apart. So catch you then. Thank you. Okay, we need to window unit, and last is when one piece. We shall bring you back when I've got it out. Okay, vehicle's disassembled. Now, the glass or the lights on the front here were broken anyway. So we have both pieces. So we may glue them into the back of that. Or we may put jeweled lights in, most likely the latter. Glass is in fair condition, needs to be cleaned up and polished, but no cracks. I made the hole there a little bit bigger, so she shouldn't crack any further. Now a piece from Paul from Pimp My Diecasts. The item that's been repainted, but we shall bring that back to black. Our interior, of course. Our steering wheel, we'll keep that as it is. The base we'll clean up. But, the tyres seem to be all okay. All the chrome's there. We may do a wheel swap, don't know yet. A plastic base, and of course our castings. Now I'm not pulling the doors or bonnet off because difficult to get this part here out. So the bonnet will stay in and the doors will stay in. Alright, so what are we going to do next? Good question. I'll see you in a moment and we shall find out. Okay, should you wish to take the bonnet and doors out, just be very careful, because see this spring here, that is held by crimped posts, so to speak, and if you pry them just slightly apart, that they are very fragile. As you can see here, that pin comes out. This piece comes out, and then you can lift the bonnet out. If you don't do that, you won't get the bonnet out. And the same thing with the doors. You need to lever under the top edge or the bottom edge, depending on how you're holding the car, of the hinge. Yeah, it's all like the top of the hinge down there. But these are still rather tight, so I shall leave the doors in. I am going to put the bonnet back in. And I'll have to glue that pin, that retaining pin, back in on this occasion. See what happens when you're not careful enough. Things do break. Anyway, it's not a major issue. It's not outside. So, just so you're aware that if you're doing the K95 Audi Quatro and you're stripping it completely, pulling it apart, that's what you need to do. So, anyway, I'll keep crack-a-lacking, as PB Pete would say, and we'll be back in a moment. So, we're in the fabulous venue. The audience is ready, which means that you're ready. Our performers here are ready. They're just wanting to have their bath. So here we go. They're working quite well. They're taking some of their stuff off. Go for a little bit more. They've taken a little bit more off. And They said that they wanted to go into the deep end. So, let's do that. Oh, they're working well for this. We can see all our paint's coming off. Around the front. Not that there was all that much paint on the car to start with. But, here we go. We'll just pour the rest of it in. And the sides come off. Well, we'll let the girls do their business. We'll come back in a moment with a bit of audience participation. I will throw this plastic scoop part in to take that paint off once this has cooled down a little bit. Alright, we shall come back with some audience participation
with a naked vehicle.
So, bit of an update. We now have driving lights restored because there were four missing. We put dual headlights in. We have polished up the screen and we've taken the paint off the spoiler. And as you just saw a moment ago, we're taking the paint off the car. So now we need to polish it up a little bit. Don't know why we need to polish it, but it's to take the residue, excuse me, just had some lunch, to take the residue off the caustic soda, or if you're using paint stripper, same sort of thing. Once it's been washed down, I just use a brass bristle brush these days. Used to use the wire wheel on the Dremel. The reason I don't use it anymore is because all the bristles go all over the place. You know, so it'll get into your clothes. So there's half the car, as you can see, half of it's shiny. And half of it, not so much. Once I do the brass bristles, I'll use this scourer thing from, what's it called? It's called from Beta, Power Scrub Stainless Steel Scourer. And I'm still on my first one. And if you've been watching my channel for a little while, I've been using it for quite a few months. And I don't have the mess on here as you do with the steel wool. This works just as well, but for everybody their own. So again, all I'm doing is just going to park the vehicle so you can see it's where we've been, shiny, to where not so shiny. The rest I'll do off camera. When we come back, the vehicle will be in primer. Okay, I've been advised to change the colour from what I was going to paint it to something different by the guys in the DMC Tavern. So they said I was going to paint it a blue colour, a very nice blue colour actually. But they said no, paint it the colour for ashes to ashes. And when I looked it up on the internet, it was, to me, it looks red. So that's what we're going to do. So if I don't like it, I can always paint it later. Anyway, so here we go. Let's see if the Taverners were right. Thank you. be able to paint it properly. The paint that I'm using is a decanted spray can. Actually, quite, to me, that looks quite nice like that. No masking up, and yeah, maybe we'll see. Anyway, I'll keep going. We'll put a tack coat on. Open up the door slightly to the those, if I can open them up without spilling anything. Do the shuts. Oops. Get my fingers around the right way before I lose everything, and there goes the punch. Good thing I had some paper down. Anyway, things happen. Enough paint in there to finish off what I need to do for the moment. As long as I didn't lose the car. So I'm not worried about that. I'm going to let that dry and I'll finish that off. We'll come back at the reveal. See you then. Just a reminder as to what we started with on this Matchbox Speed Kings Audi Quatro. Rough paintwork. Spoiler provided by Pimp My Die Casks. Thank you, Paul. And this is where we are now. And wasn't this a barrel of laughs? This was the Matchbox Speed Kings Audi Quattro. And the original colour I wanted to paint it was a blue. But I listened to the Taverners at the diecast and modellers community, who said, no, don't paint it blue, otherwise you're banned. Paint it the ashes colours. So we have finally succeeded after 8 attempts. Now, I put the 8 attempts down to, if you look at the spoiler, this came from Paul from Pimp My Diecast, who also tried to do an ashes to ashes with the same model. But he had a terrible outcome. So that's where I put the blame on why I had to do this 8 times. So each time a different layer, we got some fish eyes. So even though we have some minor defects on this one, I'm happy with it. And I'm not painting it red again. So, hope you enjoyed this little video. And my little rant here at the end. Bonnet does open, by the way. There is an engine in there. I'm still pleased with it. It has a little bit of on this corner here. It's not that noticeable, and it's my car. So in the end, I am happy with it that we got it finally done. But it was a challenge. Again, I hope you enjoyed the video. We'll catch you on the next time of Gravesend Australia Diecast Salvage. Bye for now.